Hello everyone, myself Shweta Shah. I'm your instructor for the subject Computer Organization and Architecture. In this subject, we are going to start Unit 5, that is Central Processing Unit. And in this unit, we are going to see today the topics, that is Introduction and Stack Organization. Before starting with the topic, let me see what are the outlines for this Unit 5. Outline for this unit are Introduction, Stack Organization, General Register Organization, Instruction Format, Addressing Modes, then we will see Data Transfer and Manipulation and Program Control Instructions, then we will see Subroutine Call and Return, then Interrupt, then RISC and CISC Machines, and then we will see Overlapped Register Print. So these are the outline for this whole Unit 5. Before starting with the topic, that is Stack Organization, let first we see what is the CPU, or you can say Central Processing Unit. So, the part of computer that performs the bulk of data processing operation is called as a central processing unit. We are also calling it as a CPU. Okay, so it is shown over here in this figure. It mainly containing three parts. These are control, register set, and ALU. Here, the register set stores the intermediate data that are used during the execution of instruction. Then we will have ALU to perform this arithmetic and logical micro operation that we require in this instructions. Then we will have the control unit that supervise the transfer of information among the registers and the instruction that ALU as to which operation perform. Okay, so this is the major part for your CPU, that is control, register set, and ALU. Okay, so let me further move to the our actual topics, that is stack organization. So a stack is a storage device that stores your information in a such a manner that the item stored last is the first item that you can return. Okay, so the register that holds the address of the stack is known as a stack pointer, or you can say called, you can call it as a SP. Okay, because it always the tops at the stack. Okay, so the physical register of the stack are always available for reading and writing, and its contained of the word that is inserted or deleted from the stack. Okay, so mainly we will have two register. One is a stack pointer to point the location, and second one is a physical register to store the content from that location given by stack pointer, or to store the content at the location that is given by stack pointer. Okay, so the majorly we will require to perform two operation. That is inserting data into stack, and second is deletion of data from stack. Okay, the operation of insertion is known as a push, because it can be thought of as a result of pushing a new item on the top, and the operation of deletion is known as a pop, or you can say pop-up operation. Okay, because we are it can be thought as a result of removing one item so that the stack pop. Okay, so there is, we are going to use two operation, that is push operation and pop operation. And a stack can be organized into two manner, that can be your register stack, or that can be your memory stack. This register stack is built using registers, and memory stack is a, some you can say as a logical part of memory that you have already attached to your CPU, and you are using it as a stack. Okay, so you can organize this stack in two manner, by means of register or by means of inbuilt memory. Okay, so a stack can be placed in portion of large memory, or it can be organized as a collection of finite number of memory words or register. Here let me see first as a register stack. Here I have shown the stack, which is containing total 64 register, that is starting from 0, 1, 2 up to 63. So we have total 64 registers, so we can say it as a 64 word register stack. Okay, here we have two extra flags, that is known as a full and empty. stack pointer to point the location in the stack, and data register to store the content from the location that is given by stack pointer to that register. Okay, so DR register you can also known as a physical register. Okay, so this is the structure for your register stack. Here the stack pointer register SP and the address of the word that is currently on the top of the stack. Okay, so your stack pointer always points at the top of the stack. Three items we have placed over here, that is A, B, C. Okay, and this order, like A first, then B, and then C. So C is on the top and it is at location 3. So your stack pointer's content is a 3, as we have seen over here. Your stack pointer's content is indicating top of your stack. So it is indicated at location 3, which where you have stored C. Okay. To remove the top item, the stack is popped by reading the memory word at address 3 and decrementing the content of stack pointer by 1. So after popping C, your stack pointer will be 2. To insert new item, stack is pushed by incrementing stack pointer SP and writing the word in the next higher location in the stack. So if you want to push the data into this stack, so your stack pointer will be incremented by 1, that is it will be by incremented by 1, that means it is already 3, so it will be next time it will be 4, and then your content is going to be stored over there. Okay, here our stack is of 64 words stack, and its stack pointer should contain 6 bit. Why 6 bit? Because we have total 64 locations to address, and to address this 64 location we will require 2 raised to 6, that is equals to 64. So we will require 6 bits to represent whole address of this all 64 registers. Okay, so our registers address, or you can say stack pointers content, will be from 00000 to 111111. Okay, so your maximum address is 6 times 1, it can't exit from that. Okay, so when your address is 63 and if you increment it by 1, then your result will be 1 and then 6 times z, but you are going to store only 6 bits into stack pointer. So your content of stack pointer will be 00000. Okay, so you can say that your stack is full. Okay, and similarly, when your address, or you can say when your stack pointer's content is 00000, and if you decrement it by 1, then your result will be 6 times 1 with borrow 1. Okay, your content will be 6 times 1. Okay, so you can't exit from that. So we have to use one extra bit to represent this, your that your stack is full or your stack is empty. If your stack's register, or you can say SP, is 63 and if you increment it by 1, that means your stack is full. And if your stack pointer's counter is 0000, and if you decrement this by 1, that means your stack is already empty. Okay, so to represent this empty and full stack, we are going to use two flags. Full is set to 1 when your stack is full, and empty flag is set to 1 when your stack is empty. So we are going to use these two flags to represent your stack, whether your stack is full or empty. If your stack is full, then you can store data in next data into it, or if your stack is empty, so you can't retrieve data from it. Okay, so we have to see this. And data register is the that hold the binary data to be written into or read out of the stack, that we have already discussed. Okay, so for this register stack, for push operation, that means we want to store data into stack. So for that, we will first require to increment the stack pointer by 1, then we will store this data that already available into data register to the stack, so that your pushing of data into stack is done. But after that, we will require to see whether your stack is full or not. If your stack is full, that means you can't store next data. Okay, so we will require to check that thing also. So how we can check it? Let me see. So for push operation, for a resistor stack, first you will require to increment the content of stack by 1. That is, we are representing it as SP is going to be updated like SP plus 1. So your stack pointer is incremented by 1. Then your content of data resistor is going to be stored into stack pointer's memory location. Or you can say memory location that is given by stack pointer. Then we will see whether your stack pointer is 0. If your stack pointer is 0, that means your already content of this stack pointer would be 11111, and you have incremented it by 1, so that your result will be 1 and then 6 times 0, and you have stored this 6 times 0 into stack pointer. If after incrementing stack pointer, if content of this stack pointer is 000, that means your stack is full. Okay, and if it is full, then you have to mark this full flag by 1. Otherwise, your stack is empty. Okay, so you will put empty as a 0. That means you can store data into stack. Next, we will see pop operation. For pop operation, what we require to do? We first require to store the content that is given by a stack pointer's location to the data resistor, and then decrement the stack pointer by 1. After decrementing this stack pointer, if your stack pointer's counter is 00000, that means your stack is empty. So we require to identify empty flag by 1. Okay, whenever your stack pointer is 0 after decrementing. Okay, and if your stack pointer is not 0, that means your stack is not empty. Okay, so how we can represent it? It can be represented like this. First, we will require to store the memory locations content given by stack pointer to the data resistor, then decrement the stack pointer by 1, and then check whether stack pointer is 0 or not. If it is 0, then your stack is empty, so represent empty flag by 1. If it is not 0, then your stack is not full. So we will represent it as a full by 0. That means your stack is not full. Okay. So by this way, we can do the push and pop operation for your resistor stack. In that, for pushing, you have to increment the stack pointer. For popping, you have to decrement the stack pointer. Okay. So this is your resistor stack. Next, we will see memory stack. How you can organize the memory stack? A memory stack can be implemented in random access memory attached to CPU as shown in a figure that we will see in the next slide. To implement this stack of CPU, it is done by assigning the portion of the memory to this stack operation and using processor register as a stack pointer. This figure shows the portion of computer memory partition into 3 segments, that is program, data and stack. This program program segment, which contains your instruction that can be accessed by program counter. Okay, so you can use program counter to access this program segment. Address register, or you can say AR register to access your data, and you can use stack pointer to access your stack. Okay, and these 3 registers are connected to a common address bus, and either of one can provide address for the memory. Okay, how it is connected? Let me see with this figure. Here we have divided this memory into 3 parts, that is program memory, second one is a data memory, and third one is a stack memory. Program memory can be accessed by program counter, address memory can be accessed by, or you can say data memory can be accessed by address register, and stack can be accessed by stack pointer. Okay, so here we for designing memory stack, we have to assign the address. We have assigned maximum possible address to the stack pointer. Okay, so here maximum possible address is a 4001, so that we have assigned that address to the stack pointer. To store the content at the location at the stack, we are going to store this from one location before that location. That means if you have assigned 4001 to the stack pointer, then you will store the content from location 4000 onwards. Okay, so your first data is going to be stored at a 4000. Then this then pushing another data, you first require to decrement the stack pointer by one. That means your stack pointer will be 3999, and you will store next data. And for storing next onwards, you have to first require to decrement the stack pointer and the store data. Why that is? Because we have assigned maximum possible address to the top of the stack. So to store data onwards, you have to decrement the address. Okay. So let me see how we can do. Okay. So first we see how we can do this push operation. So for push operation, first you will require to decrement the content of stack pointer by one and store the content of data register to the location that is given by a stack pointer. So your data will be pushed into stack. That means you first require to decrement the stack pointer and store and push. Okay. And for pop operation, you will require first to store the data that is given by a stack pointer's location to the data register and then increment the stack pointer by one so that your that content that is stored at that location is deleted. Okay, so and always stack pointer always indicate the top of the stack, so you have to increment address by one so that your stack pointer represents your top of the stack. So we can use like this push and pop operation for your memory stack. For register stack, what you require? You require to first increment the stack pointer and store your data. For memory stack, for push operation, you first require to decrement the stack pointer and store. Vice versa for pop operation. Okay. So the use of this stack organization is we are going to use in a reverse Polish notation. The common mathematical method of writing arithmetic expression imposes difficulty when it is evaluated by computer. The common arithmetic expression are written in a infixed notation with operator written in between the operands and consider, let me consider one a simple operation, that is A into B plus C into D. For our normal operation, what we will do, we will use this operator in between your operands. Okay, but it will be hard for a computer to understand which operation it required to do. For computers, we are going to use this prefix or postfix notification to represent this arithmetic operation. A plus B is your infix notation. To represent this prefix form, first you have to give its operation and then your operand. That is, your operation is of addition. So you will first provide plus and then A, B. So that your this is known as a your prefix notation. And similarly for postfix, you will first provide the operands and then operator. Okay, so A and B first provided and then operation, that is we are going to do addition, so plus is next provided. So that is known as a reverse Polish operation. So similarly for this operation A into B plus C into D, we can write it as a A B star, then C, D, star and plus, so that your whole operation, then a whole operation can be performed in a this manner and it will be easy for your computer system. So we can write it as a A, B star, C, D star, plus. So let me see further by using this arithmetic operation, that is 3 into 4 plus 5 into 6. It is your normal representation. In prefix representation, or you can say in reverse Polish notation, we can write it as a 3, 4 star, 3 and 4 multiplied, then 5 and 6 multiplied, and then lastly we have done addition, that is 3, 4 star, 5, 6 star and plus. How this operation can be done into stack? Let me see with this example. So first we will push what? 3, then we will push 4. And then we will push the notation, that is your star notation. Okay, so the operation on the stack of the top of the stack will be done, that is 4 multiplied by 3, and the result is going to be stored at the top of the stack, so it is going to be stored as a 12. Then we will enter 5, then we will enter 6, and then we will enter the operator multiplication. So what will be done when we enter multiplication operator? Then it will pop the top of the stack to contain, that is 6 and 5, and then it will do operation of multiplication. So result will be 30, and that is going to be stored at the top of the stack. That is that 5 and 6 already you have written. Then your result will be 30, and that is going to be stored at top. So we are going to store 30 at over here. Then we will provide the plus operation. So what it will be do? It will do the addition of this top of the stack. So the addition of 30 and 12 is done over here, and the result of that operation is going to be stored over top of the stack. So it is your 42. So your stack organization is very much useful when you are doing some arithmetic operation with reverse polished notation. Okay. So we are ending our today's session over here. If you have any query, then please feel free to contact me. Thank you for watching.